बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड। फ्रॉम 6 अप्रैल टिल 8 मे यू हैव कम्प्लीटेड चैप्टर नंबर 6, एक्सरसाइज 6.1 टिल 6.5। आई होप यू ऑल हैव मेड द नोट्स इन रजिस्टर्ड एंड यू हैव टू रिवाइज इट अगेन एंड अगेन, बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू बोर्ड पैटर्न चैप्टर नंबर 6 इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एज वन लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन ऑलवेज कम from this chapter in the final paper. So must prepare it well, must practice review exercise 6 and must learn summary as well. Let's start today's work. Week number 6, from 11th May till 15th May, we are going to start chapter number 3, business mathematics. Exercise 3.1 is all about profit and loss. You all are familiar with these two terms. Let's see what is this. Today's exercise is about profit and loss, and at the end of this exercise students will be able to recognize cost price, sale price, profit and profit percentage. Identify the following relations regarding profit when SP will be greater than CP. Obviously when SP is greater then you will get profit, otherwise not. Keep in mind students that you have to see page number 44 which is in book. You have to learn all these formulas from there and you have to apply only these formulas which I have written in this slide. If you will apply only these formulas in exercise 3.1, you can get the answer within 2 minutes. In profit and loss, trader purchase and sell goods and services. The trader may earn profit and loss, and you should know that in profit and loss, you will need two relations, cost price and sale price. Let's see what is cost price. The price at which a particular item is purchased by shopkeeper is called cost price. Selling price, the price at which an article is sold out to the customer by the shopkeeper is called the selling price. Profit term is very easy. If you sell an article at a greater price than its cost price, then we say that you got profit. Loss, if the sale price of an article is less than its cost price, then there is always a loss. Students, you all are familiar with all these definitions, but as we can get any objective from these definitions, so we have to learn the definitions, we have to learn the summary as well. So please be prepared, because anything can come from anywhere, so you have to learn each and everything carefully. Now here some terminologies we will use in profit formula, that is cost price, selling price, profit and profit percent. Now here again some terminologies we will use in loss, that is cost price, selling price, loss and loss percent. Mostly we are going to use all these four formulas in the exercise 3.1, so learn all these formulas carefully. For profit, SP minus CP. For finding the profit percent, profit over CP into 100. Keep in mind that you always divide profit with CP, not with SP, for finding the profit percent. For the next formula, if SP you want to find out, then you have to use CP into profit percent plus 100 over 100. If you want to find out CP, then you have to use SP into 100 over 100 plus profit formula. Learn all these formulas with written practice so you can apply easily in the exercise. Here I want to tell you again what is loss. If the sale price of an article is less than its cost price, then there is a loss. Simply, if you have loss, you have to use CP minus SP formula. Similarly, if loss percent you want to find out, you have to use loss over CP into 100. If you want to find out simple loss, where loss percent or CP given, then you can use this formula CP over 100 into loss percent. If CP is required, then you can use 100 into SP over 100 minus loss percent. If you want to find out SP, then you can easily use CP into 100 minus loss percent over 100. Keep in mind, you can easily get the idea if you will write it down given and to find. If you will write down given and to find, you can easily judge what formula is going to apply in the given situation. All these formulas are written on page number 50. You can easily learn and you can easily practice from page 50. Let's start today exercise 3.1. In question number 1, find SP when cost price or profit percent given. On other side, cost price and loss percent given. I have written 4 formulas and you have to apply all these formulas according to the given situation. All these same formulas you will apply for question number 3 as well. So must practice it again and again. You can get the reference from page 44 and 50 as well. As I told you in start, students, you have to practice each and everything from the book. So here I have solved examples which are also very important, and you must have to solve all these examples in your classwork copies. So here a shopkeeper has bought 1 kg of apple for rupees 100 and sold it for rupees 120. How much is the profit? Very simple, everything is clear. Cost price given, selling price given. Just find out profit, you will get the answer. On other side, by selling a watch for rupees 990, a shopkeeper gets a loss of 10%. Find the cost of watch for shopkeeper. Here loss percent given, SP given, you have to find out CP. This formula is written on page number 50. Must practice it again and again. You will just put the values and get the answer. Students, here a cycle was purchased for rupees 1600. Purchase mean cost price given and sold sale price given. Find loss and loss percent. Very simple, CP given, SP given. Simply apply loss formula and get the answer. For the loss percent, always divide with CP, not with SP. Loss over CP into 100, put the values, you will get the answer of loss percentage. On other side, you have done all you have done this question already in question number 1 or in question number 3, so there will be no problem. Must learn all the formulas carefully and practice it. In question number 2, Harish purchased a car for rupees 2,48,000 and spent rupees 12,000 on its denting and painting. He sold at a profit of 5%. What did the customer pay to Harish? Here we have to highlight that what is the total price of a car, that is 2,48,000. After spending 12,000 on its denting and painting, then total cost of car will be 2,60,000 now. Now on this cost price, Harish wants to sell it, and that selling price is SP is equal to CP into 100 plus profit percent over 100. Since CP is given, profit percent given, you have decided this formula and now apply the values, you will get the final answer for the SP. Question number 4, a shopkeeper gains a profit of 7% by selling a dinner set for rupees 3,852. If he sells it for rupees 4,050, find his profit percentage. In this question, I am going to divide this question in 2 equal parts. First of all, I will consider till full stop, that is shopkeeper gain, profit percent given, selling price given. Find out the CP. CP formula you have already learned. Put the values and find the answer, that is CP 3600. After that, in second half, SP is also given, that is 4050 rupees. Simply apply profit formula, that is SP minus CP. You will get the answer of profit. After finding the profit from value, you have to find out profit percentage, that is profit over CP into 100, and you will get the answer. Keep in mind, always divide profit with CP, not with SP, so that you can get the profit percentage answer. The selling price of 12 article is equal to the cost price of 15 article. Find the profit percentage. In this question, we are going to consider sale price of each article is rupees 1. So selling price of 12 article is equal to 12 into 1, 12. Cost price of 15 article is equal to 15 into 1, 15. since both are equal to each other, so selling price of 12 article will be equal to cost price of 15 article. In the question, if we are going to find out profit percentage, so we have to consider the big value as sale price. So selling profit formula is SP minus CP, 15 minus 12, answer is 3. After that, profit percentage, profit over CP into 100, you will get the answer. Question number 6, find the cost price if a fan is sold for rupees 1470 to get a profit 1 over 6th of its cost price. Since cost price is missing, so we are going to write it down profit as 1 over 6 of CP. Let's start CP as X rupees. Profit is X over 6 now. Of mean multiply, so you will multiply 1 over 6 into X. This is now X over 6. Now SP is missing, so you will use SP is equal to profit plus CP formula. Put the values. Your answer is 7x over 6 after taking the LCM. 7x over 6 is equal to 1470. For making x alone, you will shift 7 over 6 to other side. It will come in reciprocal form, that is 1470 into 6 over 7. You will get the answer 1260. Question number 7. A man sold an almirah at profit 7 whole 1 over 2%. Had he sold it for rupees 209, he would have lost 2% for how much the man purchased it. In this question, we are going to find out cost price, where I can easily see the lost percent is given and profit percent given. Since the selling after selling price, he is getting loss, so we are going to neglect 7 whole 1 over 2. It means sale price is 209, loss percent 2%, CP is missing. Apply the formula and get the answer. 3 chairs are purchased at rupees 450 each. One of these is sold at loss of 10%. At what price should the other two be sold so as to gain 20% on the whole transaction? I am going to solve till first full stop, that is 3 chairs. 3 chairs cost price of each is 450. Multiply 450 with 3, your answer is 1350. Moving on, CP of each chair 450, loss is 10% of CP. When you divide 10 over 100 into 450, your answer is 45. Then moving on, SP, that is CP minus loss, 450 minus 45, your answer of SP is 405. For the second full stop, for the whole transaction, profit percent given, profit percent of CP, that is 20 over 100 into 1350, your answer is 270. SP of 3 chairs is equal to CP plus profit, that is 1350 plus 270 is equal to 1620. Moving on, SP of other 2 chairs is equal to SP of 3 chairs minus SP of first chair. 1620 minus 405 is equal to 1215 answer. Now do this question again and again, as this is very important for board point of view. Today students, you have learned about exercise 3.1, profit and loss, and all the formulas I discussed with you, that how to apply and when to apply. First of all, keep 2-3 points in your mind, that you have to read the statement carefully. Number 2, you have to underline what is given and what you have to find out. After that, you can easily judge what type of formula you are going to apply. So today, exercise 3.1, question number 1-8, I have tried my best to show all the questions in my slide. So you can learn from here and must practice all these questions in your registers. With this, thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.